tried upholstering that step, and I upholstered the board upside down, and if I try and turn it around, the cutout there is the wrong shape. Now I've got to figure out what to do. Do I rip the whole thing off and redo it, or just cut the board a little differently? So I cut the corner off the cushion, which made it a lot easier to cover, just having a 45 degree angle instead of having it shaped where it had to be to let the table go down. And then I was able to put it in, basically the board's upside down from the way I originally cut it, and it now has the cushion on top. So now I'm just putting the bed back together so I can get on with other tasks, but we'll have to see what happens when I get Jenny in here to test this. I just installed a switch here. The one that's off is currently not used for anything, but the one that I connected, that is the one that flips on the DC to DC charger back there, which uses the battery that's isolated or the incoming current from the motor that's charging it, which I haven't got running right now, and it charges our house battery. When I connected it, it was at 40 amps. The capacity of the charger is 60. It's currently gone down to 30. And I did this while the battery was at 95%. But that percentage isn't accurate because this is part of calibrating it. I've got to fully charge the house battery. Then I can set 100%. And then this guy is going to give correct measurements. So for now, we're just letting it charge. And I have to ignore the percentage. But if I can't do it within an hour, I'll have killed the 12-volt battery. I'll have to run the motor.
We're using this battery package and box to make a cushion. Can you go back to your bed? You go back to your bed.
Walk in the Shadowland, nobody's innocent, hand to mouth, we live like demons. Stuck in the Phantom Zone, lost in a Thunderdome, twilight ruled the day. We found the impossible, now we're unstoppable, taking off the world beneath us. Strong under pressure, we'll make it together, our universe will change. Freedom looking down a telescope, starlight never been so beautiful. Whole world waiting for us, time to go, escaping gravity. We'll be rising high above the rising sunset, never gonna be the same. Thunder calling us to outer space, escaping gravity. Escaping gravity.
The bench get the cover on.
Use it. Oh, this piece of padding from the battery, it's nice and firm. Now I also put switches here on the side.
Okay.
This one I can reach from the driver's seat. And if I turn this on, little Gray then will use her alternator to charge this battery. And boy, does she charge fast.
Okay. So we have decided to take down this closet.
In testing, especially after we put this one up, we decided that this one, unfortunately, you just couldn't use the kitchen table and sleep sideways or anything with this here. So
yeah, because I don't like my head bump into it.
Yeah.
Kaya is cozy there.
Oh yeah. Oh, you know what else I did?
What?
Two more sockets, but two of them go to the front battery, the one that we didn't really have any other stuff connected to.
Yeah.
So now I can plug in stuff there, like hair dryer. Let's take a look inside the diesel heater cupboard. There was space here for storage, so we put in this board, and the diesel heater's below, but I've turned it. I had to. First of all, to make that go out there, that was the most important thing. The air vent had to come out so it wasn't aimed at the fridge. I run the exhaust pipe a different way, and when I did temperature tests in here, it actually runs a heck of a lot cooler, and the section back to the wheel there is pretty short. These little other stacks of lumber are folded together, and they're for leveling the wheels. Interestingly enough, there's a little siphon hose in that baggie, and an empty pop bottle. In an emergency, that's one way to get diesel into the heater. The other way is putting the can up here and siphoning it in. I tried pouring it, and I was getting dribbles, and I just can't have dribbles in the van. Okay, so Jenny, I want you to open the newest cabinet there.
This one?
Yeah. So you remember you have to push fairly and then pull it out. Yeah.
Oh, so this stands. Okay, that's cool.
Yeah.
Because otherwise we have
Oh, to that was terrible having to hold it up.
Oh, that's
Yeah.
Good. Yeah. Anything else?
Well, I put the same thing on here, but the purpose is different here. These make this thing so you can put a bit of weight on here, whereas before I was afraid I'd break the door off. So now we can actually put stuff on here. Oh, and look at this. We're running the diesel heater, but this little red mark here says we're still charging 3/4 of an amp on top of whatever we're draining to run the diesel heater.
Hey, this is cool without that cabinet.
Oh, you're at home already.
Yeah.
Aha. Uh-huh.
To bump into anything, so yep. Kaya has to go there.
Kaya goes under the cabinets.
Yeah. Kaya, you go to the cabinet, right? She says no.
Okay, so Jenny,
you want to show me this?
Yes. I'm still getting confused on what the buttons do. is it minus or plus? Oh, I think it's 1 and 0. 1 is on.
Would you turn it on?
Nothing's happened. There.
Oh, that light.
And they're dimmable, like they don't look very bright now, and they dim a bit. And they have a timer. You can have it timed so it'll be on for 30 minutes.
Those are for those two lights.
This is, when it's pitch dark at night and we wanted some light, that like maybe for reading or something, but we don't want the big bright light on, we can have those. And they run off rechargeable.
Oh, you added those two lights. Yeah, I didn't see them.
They're rechargeable cells. And I put them right where the built-in van lights are. So I know it doesn't look very bright now because we're in the daylight, but they're going to look pretty good when it's pitch dark inside and we don't really want it to be overly bright. Okay. Oh, Kai's seen something outside.
And the hair is up.
Yeah. Yeah. Ooh.
No barking. No, no. Good girl. No barking. You're okay. You're okay.
Humming's acceptable. So because it's infrared, if I point it at one light, it turns on and the other doesn't.
That is pretty good, because in the night, you don't want it.
You don't even want both on.
What did you do here?
Okay, so I put in this little frame with a circle here for the base of the propane tank, and this handle here, so it holds it rigid, and you can still see the gauge to know how much propane we've got. So to take it out, all I do is disconnect the hose, and as I turn the propane cylinder, it moves over to this gap, and then I can just lift it out.
The other thing is this propane okay stay in outside very cold?
Yes, I found it seems to work okay, that big a cylinder. Okay, Jenny, back home from work, and what have we got?
You said you're gonna see, where are you gonna store this?
I'll show you.
So, you said you take it
on Yeah, here? And then slip it under the mattress for a little bit. And then see this little post here.
Yeah.
Goes right there. There.
Oh, okay.
Now fold the mattress back. Mm-hmm. And just push it in. Yeah. So when we're driving, it's not going to come out, and the bedboard is in there because there's a post under here that goes down into the bedboard that keeps it there. And the other one is under here, and it fits quite well. So that's the one that would be in this area under the table. So we have the battery monitor is working. That now gives us an accurate reading of how much battery we have left for the whole holiday.
So you got
this mat, I bought it. It's the right size, but I found I was kicking it all over the place. So it's currently fixed to the floor. We have to just wipe it when it gets dirty.
Oh.
And then we have our, it's actually three of these mats made to fit in here. And if you check the cupboards, you will find that sure enough, they open easy. And that includes the one for the water jug, which had to be trimmed. I rounded the edges on the table.
Yeah, that's flawless. This is better.
I think that'll be better for Kaya. Yeah. And then up in the cupboard there,
you got your slippers.
I have my slippers that are dedicated to this van. And I'm going to put a shelf in that slants slightly backwards up at the top to help stuff at the top stay in. So, you see, Kaya looks very at home on our new carpet. Don't you, Kaya?
Did I put another layer
on
here?
Oh, another layer? No, you need slippers. So here's the battery box with the battery removed. The story is that when we got to a few days of real cold, like 17 below, it stopped charging. And I checked the specifications. The manual said that you could store it down to zero, but you could operate it down to minus 20. I have since researched lithium iron phosphate batteries. In fact, operating means discharging. You can't charge them below zero. They get lithium metal collecting all over the anode and basically wiping out the life very quickly. So I insulated the bottom of the cabinet where the battery sits, and I bought four little tiny heating pads. They're like 12 volt direct connect and 20 watt. I was going to connect them to a battery, but the problem is eventually something is liable to get too warm. Now, first of all, I connected them in two pairs of series and found that at instead of 20 watt, it's down to about 9.5 watt. I found that they in an outside test, they didn't get hot enough to concern me. They went somewhat above body temperature. So I have two pairs of serially connected heating pads sitting on top of, and I've stuck them down with double-sided tape to the insulation. I've also got the temperature probe for my thermostat and the temperature probe for the battery monitor. And you can see that one's closer to the heaters. It's supposed to help them turn off and on when required. And this one's sort of a double check to make sure it's really not terribly cold. So I bought this industrial thermostat. It's currently set to heat up to 2 degrees above zero. And it's currently minus decimal 1 degree. And the light on says that it has turned on the circuit. And since I've connected it temporarily to this battery, it's discharging. We're warming them up. And the idea is I want to leave them for quite a while and make sure they all get evenly warm, which is going to be like body temperature more or less, maybe a bit more. And by then I'll know they're all heating evenly and they're fine. Then I can put my battery in and actually start to do a test where it's powering itself. Hopefully going to warm up enough that the thermostat kicks in, or at least kicks out and stops trying to warm them. So 5 minutes into my test. I found that putting my hand on it, well, great hand warmer. It's just comfortably warm. Just for fun, let's make this cycle. So skin temperature over the heater. Oh, there we go. And it's off. It's going up fast. Okay, so now I'm going to take my hand off and it can start going down again as it cools. I'm just going to run this for a while and just see if they get hotter than I like. So I have the battery wired up. The box I'm going to screw back together in a minute. I'm just testing everything. The battery's charging after I warmed it up in the house. Heater, I turned it on, and it's registering 11.4 degrees. And it's not going to come on until 2. So I'll have to see how cold I can get the battery. It took quite a long time in the cold snap to actually cool down. I used to watch it going down like 6 and 5, 4, you know, and all the way down. As soon as it got to -2, that was where it shut down. So that represented 0 internally where it was measuring it. Okay, so we've made a change now to the cupboard under the galley. There's now two shelves, three compartments, but I wanted to talk about this one.
I had been resisting putting in drawers like so many people put in RVs, because by the time you go to the edge here and you've got the distance between the drawer and the side wall of the drawer, that's a half inch of actual runner to allow the drawer to come out. There's a half inch of runner. Now, if I built a drawer, it would be out of half inch melamine, so that makes an inch. It makes an inch on each side. Whereas if I take all that out, I have the extra inch on each side, additional in space to store stuff. So here's the problem. I realize you don't get that problem when you put in a slider, because you can still go side to side and then wheel the whole thing out. However, what we need to store here is things like our little jars with our coffee supplies and our spices and all that sort of stuff. It all has to be organized. And so we had to put little drawers in, or little boxes in. And the only way to put the little boxes in, even though I use quarter inch plywood, they can't go on top of the runner on the drawer, because they'd go uphill. So they'd be on a slant if I put them right to the edge. So now we have a drawer that slides out that has all this stuff. And the idea is you pick the boxes up and put them on the counter when you're cooking to be able to use the stuff in them. I had to lower the next shelf down, so we have room for a square bowl for making dough, as well as this, which right now is a food hamper. And behind it, we're still storing our pressure cooker right at the back there. It fits so well.
Okay, watch this. I made these for our containers.
Oh.
They're magnets. They're little, I made little fridge magnets, and they stick to the metal tops, so we can label whatever we're putting in these jars.
Cool.
So I thought of everything I could come up with that might go in jars and made labels for them. So that's why there's too many. Earlier, I had so much air coming in around the unbuilt galley. The fridge stood on a little square pedestal. I've now converted that, so there's a lot of airflow underneath, because there's no other source of fresh air for it to go through the back of the fridge. So now I'm going to put the fridge on these two little mounts, and under it will be space for air to go in. Above it, below the bed, will be a place for air to come out of that grill, and then it flows along and out into this passageway.
Okay, in you go, Kai. In you go, Jenny.
Oh, it's cold.
Yeah, the floor is really cold. I have slippers that I keep out here. So now we can talk about
what did you do?
Some of the things we did. Now, if you get down and look under the fridge, you will notice a little vent.
Oh, yeah.
To allow the air to go in.
We didn't have that before.
No, it was blocked off because I was getting air from elsewhere. Okay, let's start with this cupboard.
Oh, you got this.
And hopefully we can get out what we need. So that's our vertical cutlery drawer. Okay, let's take a look at the new mirror.
Too short.
I haven't yet tried to angle it down a bit, so I'll have to still do that.
How about this one?
Nothing new in there at all.
Okay.
So with the battery box and the heater, anyway, I've insulated down the sides over the top, and I had previously showed where I insulated underneath and put heating elements in. The far side of this whole thing is going to be a real challenge, because it's right up against the DC to DC charger, I guess is sort of an air trap, kind of like insulation, but there's also a big gap here that's where all the cables are messing about there. Heat can escape there. So I have some work to do there, but this side of it is insulated as best I'll get. And unfortunately, there's not much I can do about this side here, because it's already got there. You have to be able to access USB ports, charging for AC and turning it on and off. It was -7 this morning, now it's 0 and the heat's turned off. And I have not been able to detect any overheating of the elements underneath. So I can basically leave that switched on a lot of the time when it's liable to go below 0.
I just pull.
You just pull the bottom all the way up until it clicks. Aha!
So you want to sit here?
Yeah, now I've got it sitting fairly straight up. So that's a place where you can put a monitor at the back and your laptop right at your waist, and you should be able to compute.
Kaya wants to go.
Oh, poor Kaya. Yeah, we don't have your stepping stool in, do we,
so
Kaya?
I have to put it down, just...
No, no! You have to release it by catches at the back on the hinge. You have to look under to see them. Okay, it's on the wall.
Oh, yeah.
those.
Yeah, so you have to release both of those to put it down. And down she goes. And then if you push it, it clicks in. Yeah.
So this one, this you added a mirror there.
Yeah, what do you think of the mirror?
Yeah, I can see it.
And I tilted
it.
Yep, and then if you lever it, it'll look towards the back of the van. So it's on a, yeah, like that. So you can sit up in bed and use the mirror.
This one didn't change anything.
It didn't, but look at that new little display.
Which one?
This one right here.
Oh, that one.
So that is actually, I haven't got it set up, so it says the battery's dead. This is monitoring the starter battery. So if we turn on to auxiliary to run the Wi-Fi, we get to see how much current we've drawn out of the battery and if it's like a dangerous situation where we're gonna run out of power. I just made one change in the electrical cupboard. I've mounted with double-sided tape my 8-unit battery charger. It's mounted on the little wall. It plugs into a USB port. Now, the other thing that normally will be kept in here as well is this case that has other electrical stuff in it, like cables and batteries and memory cards and so on. So that can all just ride in there with the iPad while we're driving, and charging can take place without this sliding all over the battery cabinet. One of our lessons learned from our previous cold weather camping trip was that underneath the mattress, the bedboard was getting condensation on it. Not quickly, but we were getting the mattress damp enough that we had to bring it in the house and dry it when we got home, and we didn't want that. It wasn't a temperature problem as far as us being cold in bed, but we didn't like the condensation. I'm thinking that it was caused by, right about here, we did feel a bit of a draft, and there's not a perfect seal here. So cold air was coming down and probably falling and ending up down here, maybe even going down towards the garage. And the garage, of course, is unheated, and so it was causing the board to be very wet, or cold rather, and then the wet from the condensation. So I've put foam board insulation under here, 1 inch thick. So I've done panel nearest galley, the back panel, which is the only place we actually had a problem. And then I also went forward and did the one here over the diesel heater muffler. The other thing I did recently was put these two straps in at the back of the cupboard on top of the diesel heater. I was going to put a board there and I decided no way. I want to be able to open it up and have a really good view of the whole diesel heater system. And so I just put the two straps there to stop anything from rolling out top of the muffler or the exhaust pipe. Yeah, we needed insulation to stop breezes coming in around the seal around the back door.
Latch, because that's a huge place of leaky air.
Yeah.
And then...
So another thing I did is this. Oh, I should make a marker at the metal.
Ah.
That way,
that's true. If we don't have any kind of a mark or something, we'll get it offside. Okay. So is that inside out? I think we were going to put it the other way, weren't we? Yeah. We thought it would look better from the inside. Yeah, that part will be harder to put in, but
I think that we're done.
I think the van's done. What do you think, Kaya? Everything I could think of is done. We elected to leave out that last bench because Jenny said she needed this space here. Well, we have the summer things to do.
When is summer?
Yeah. Wow. Isn't this cool, Kaya? Now all we need to do is to go for a trip.